Hi folks, my son and I are taking a mental health day today and we're going to drive down to Peoria, Illinois. It's about 2.5 hours southwest of Chicago and we're going to go check out some of the sites. You know, as with most people, I think everybody might have a decade of music that really that's meaningful to them, and for me, about those 10 years are about from 1975 to 85. And that's a bell curve, so you know there's more years on either side of that. But one of the musicians from that era that I really liked was Dan Fogelberg. And I never got to see him in concert, but I wish I had. So we're going to visit the memorial in Peoria that talks about his life. So I made it down here to the Illinois River at the Dan Fogelberg Memorial. So part of the plan, 1974, that must have been from his album, the one that Joe Walsh helped him with. Dan Fogelberg was discovered by Irving Azoff, who discovered REO Speedwagon from Champaign-Urbana, which is very near to here too.
If you stuck around this long, you probably already know who Dan Fogelberg is. But if you're still not sure, I'll tell you a little bit about his life as we drive up Grandview Drive. Peoria is known for maybe three things: Dan Fogelberg, the Caterpillar plants, and Grandview Drive. Grandview Drive is a 2.5-mile scenic road along the Illinois River Bluffs and connects Peoria with Peoria Heights. The drive's residential area on the west side of the drive was added to the National Register of Historic Places as a historic district in 1996. A large amount of land on the valley side of Grandview Drive is owned by the Peoria Park District and is undeveloped except for park benches. And it is said to have been one of the first linear parks of its time. World's most beautiful drive. On October 12, 1910, President Theodore Roosevelt was driven along Grandview Drive to the Country Club of Peoria, where he attended a luncheon. When his host apologized for the bumpy road conditions, Roosevelt is said to have replied, "What difference does it make? I have traveled all over the world, and this is the world's most beautiful drive." Deeper than any forest primeval, I am in love with you. Dan Fogelberg was born on August 13, 1951. His mother was a Scottish immigrant and his father was of Swedish descent. Dan graduated from Woodruff High School in 1969.
One of my favorite songs, of course, is Leader of the Band. That was song about his father, who was a music teacher here in Peoria, at a high school here in Peoria. Not only was his dad the band director at Woodruff High School, he was also band director at nearby Bradley University.
An only child alone and wild, a cabinet maker's son. His hands were meant for different work, and his heart was known to none. He left his home and went his lone and solitary way. And he gave to me a gift I know I never can repay. A quiet man of music denied a simpler fate. He tried to be a soldier once, but his music wouldn't wait. He earned his love through discipline, a thundering velvet hand. His gentle means of sculpting souls took me years to understand. The leader of the band is tired and his eyes are growing old, but his blood runs through my instrument and his song is in my soul. My life has been a poor attempt to imitate the man. I'm just a living legacy to the leader of the band. My brother's lives were different, for they heard another call. One went to Chicago and the other to St. Paul. And I'm in Colorado when I'm not in some hotel, living out this life I've chose and come to know so well. I love you near enough. The leader of the band is tired and his eyes are growing old, but his blood runs through my instrument and his song is in my soul. My life has been a poor attempt to imitate the man. I'm just a living legacy to the leader of the band. I am a living legacy to the leader of the band.
Fogelberg was diagnosed with advanced prostate cancer in May of 2004 and went into partial remission in 2005, only to return in 2007. He died at his home in Deer Isle, Maine, on December 16th of that year. In tribute to Fogelberg, Peoria named Abington Street in the city's East Bluff neighborhood Fogelberg Parkway. The street runs from the school, past the convenience store from same old Lang Syne, to the river where you can walk to the memorial.
Just for a moment I was back at school. Felt that old familiar pain. And as I turned to make my way back home,
I hope you enjoyed this short vlog and its bit of Peoria history. We'll see you next time.